Bruce, I loved Red.
Good.
It has a very positive message. It made me unafraid of getting into my 50s and 60s because it made me believe I'll be able to kick someone's ass at that age. Is that why you set out to make the film?
One of the many reasons. It would seem that there was some huge Byzantine, many-geared plan to get all these actors into one film. I think if someone really had tried to do it, they would have never accomplished it. We'd have never gotten all these actors in the same film. It came together in some spontaneous kind of strange way that is even hard for me to understand now, but I'm so glad that all those actors showed up.
Was it like dominoes? You signed on, then Morgan goes, okay, I'll do that. Then John goes, oh, Morgan's doing it, and Bruce is doing it, and so on and so forth.
Simplified, but it's a good metaphor, dominoes. It's just like your favorite football team has just showed up, and they're going to play. So it was, and everybody brought their A game, so it was fun for us as actors, and I think fun for the audience, too.
The thing about this movie as well, plus movies like Surrogates and Die Hard 4.0, all deal with aging as an action hero to some extent. Is that something that's playing on your mind at the moment? Do you see it?
No, I think it's just in the minds more of the writers, and I may lean towards those things more than I do playing towards youth, but I kind of like playing up and playing older and just exploring that, just the idea of it, because in my mind I still am, you know, 28 years old, so I don't feel, it's only when I look in the mirror that I feel the passing of time and say, wow, how did I get to 55?
Yeah, very distinguished.
Well, yes, distinguished, and you start to get those kind of compliments. Very distinguished looking this evening, Bruce, thank you.
I remember Terry Gilliam once said about you that your bald head is a monument to cranial architecture.
Well, I was talking to my daughter Tallulah the other day, and she said something very interesting. She said, maybe it's just that your time was meant to be spent on something other than worrying about your hairstyle. And I like that. I like not having to think about it. And I have a friend who has a long mane of hair, big long ponytail, spends 4 hours a day fussing with it.
Right.
So they haven't quite figured it out, but maybe Tallulah's right. Maybe there I have bigger things in store for me than to fuss with my hairstyle.
There have been rumors, probably wildly made up rumors, about a crossover between Die Hard and 24 with John McClane and Jack.
I heard that rumor too.
What's your take on that rumor?
Well, also an ambitious notion, but I think it's still in the rumor stage. What else you got?
I was going to talk about Looper because I'm very interested in that. Because
now you're talking.
You were playing, obviously, Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
I'm playing a character that meets his younger self in, what they call it on Star Trek? A space-time continuum. I don't know how it works, but it is about time travel. But the hook of the film is no one pays attention to time travel. It's just a novelty. And it's a really good script.
He's a fantastic director.
Yeah.
Very smart. Very
Ryan Johnson.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Great, great cast. And I really can't wait to start on that. It's such an interesting little story that is a big story.
Mm-hmm. Can you talk about the makeup? How they're going to do that?
Well, I wish I had brought pictures. I had to do a life cast for it. Do you know what that is?
Yeah. Very claustrophobic.
You don't ever want to do it.
No.
You never want to do it. But Joseph Gordon-Levitt is in it. Emily Blunt. Can't wait to start on that. That should be fun.
Fantastic.
Thanks for reminding me about that. One more. I'm sure you have one more question.
One more? Well, I was going to ask about The Expendables too. I know all future project stuff. But Sly has said that he'd like a bigger role of you in the sequel, possibly a fill in this role. What's he said to you?
Yes, I can't talk about the idea, but I would certainly want to do it. I think bigger, louder, more bullets, more bad guys.
Yeah.
And he's a great director, really a terrific director. I like Expendables.
Absolutely. If you had to match up the casts of Red versus the Expendables.
Well,
there's a football match.
It's just under three rounds. My team would be using the guns more.
You'd be left standing, that's all we know. Someone would be like, yeah.
Just me and Sly in a big smoky room somewhere. Big smoky stage. Thanks, man.